People say opinions are like assholes. Joe Hildebrand wipes his on any paper. But thanks to the internet, anyone can have an opinion. So I found some people with opinions who gave their opinions on how to get bang for buck for their 2 cents. This is their opinion, not my opinion. I don't have any opinions.
About everything else for people online.
You mean literally where is it worth most?
Yeah.
Newspapers still pay.
I don't know, I can't actually think of the last time I was paid for an opinion.
That would be at this stage in the papers.
So I've probably earned the most for an opinion at the Vine.
But the people who pay the best in my experience are Daily Life.
But now I do a column for Daily Life.
But it's a very specific kind of piece that Daily Life are after.
I basically mine different chunks of my almost non-existent personal life and package them up for the amusement.
And if you write too many of them, you become dumb, I think.
Where my opinion is worth the least.
Twitter.
The rest of the opinion would be given for free.
So I kind of think opinion writing in general is rubbish.
On television, all that proliferation of talk shows.
You can end your career in one opinion on Twitter and never be employed again.
If you're a professional, recognised professional in your field, then that's what pays your bills. And so if someone seeks your expertise in an editorial capacity, that's part of your job to write that.
I just spam as many editors as I have email addresses for, asking them if they want to publish my thoughts on a subject.
It's difficult because a lot of the same writers write for everyone. Like Ben Pobje, I think, writes for 800 different sources.
No, Dom, actually, I only write for 9, so maybe you can get your facts straight next time.
For online, you sort of got to get your opinion out there by the middle of the day, because that's when most people are reading.
I think you need to have 2 opinions a week if it's your only job.
Sometimes I found it hard writing opinion all the time. Sometimes I just didn't have anything to think about.
If you've actually thought about how many good opinions you have in your life, the chance of them being 100 a year is pretty slim.
You know, if I'm having to formulate an opinion on something that might not be something I really care about as much, you know, I'll still put a hell of a lot of effort into writing it and making it as funny as possible. But
I tended to be far more emphatic than I really needed to be about anything.
There are certain things that you're very passionate about, and then there are certain things that you are doing for work.
If you're writing an opinion that isn't really your opinion, then you're just writing noise.
Yeah, and sometimes I don't even bother invoicing for it. It's not really worth it.
In the good old days, even the ABC used to give you a cab charge or $50 for going on the show, but not anymore.
I don't know, Dan. We didn't really discuss fees, Dan.
I probably won't pay you anything for this. It's probably just a favour.
He said it was just a favour, so I probably won't get anything for this.
Thanks, Lewis.
Yeah, no worries.